different. I wanted to do a gear review video for a new piece of gear we've been playing with, the DJI Osmo Pocket. This little guy is designed to give you great cinematic shots as a travel vlogger or YouTuber without the heft and price of a gimbal. So we're gonna adventure around Richmond, Virginia, give it a test, and see what we think.
The DJI Osmo Pocket shoots 4K video at 60 frames a second, and that shoots slow motion at 120 frames a second at 1080p. At just under $400, this little guy fits in your pocket and has a battery life of 140 minutes, meaning it's durable, pretty long-lasting, and you can do some incredible things with it.
The DJI Osmo does have a selfie mode, so you can point it at yourself and walk and talk, a la a vlogging camera, but there's no audio interface. What it's really known for is its action shots. Lots of sweeping cinematic movement, nice, stabilized, crispy and buttery, put to some dramatic music and, well, you have a sequence. Great for cinematic sequences. All you have to do is follow along with somebody, walking down some stairs, throw to some music, and you have an awesome cinematic sequence. It fits in your pocket too, which means you can take it just about anywhere. I will say the selfie mode is not that impressive. With not a lot of microphone options and not a lot of customizable options, you really just kind of get what you get as far as the selfie mode. Where it really shines is its ability to connect wirelessly to your phone, so you can do time lapses, slow-mo, you can get some great moving time-lapse photography, really adds a great element into your videos. So cinematic sequence number two, I guess, is gonna be a time-lapse.
The DJI Osmo comes with a little Wi-Fi base. They're both small enough to fit in your pocket, so you can take them both anywhere. The little Wi-Fi base plugs into the bottom of the DJI Osmo Pocket. Once it's plugged in, you can control the camera wirelessly from your phone. You turn on the camera, find the nice solid place to set it. In this case, I'm picking a little concrete bench. Then on your phone, you use an app, just like you do with the DJI drones, to control the pocket. You have a lot of options here. You can select slow-mo, time-lapse, photo, and then you have many options. So once you select time-lapse, you can select 3-second duration, 5-second duration. You can let it run for an hour, 10 minutes. However long you like, and it'll tell you how long the time lapse will be in the final product. Then you have a little white joystick controller in the corner. You can kind of grab that joystick and move the camera around to pick a different vantage point. So you can pan up, you can pan down, you can tilt, whatever you like. In the menu settings, you have the option to select a path. A path is the kind of traveling distance of the camera. So if you find a nice point you want to start your time lapse at, you can add that as your start point of the time lapse. Then you can pan to somewhere else and add that as your end point. You can also add points in the middle so that way your camera can pan and tilt on a more complicated path. And throughout the time lapse process, the pocket will pan and tilt itself to give you a nice smooth path for your time lapse. Then you hit record and away you go.
So the time-lapse feature is pretty cool. It's really neat to be able to kind of set it and forget it on your phone and get a great time-lapse. Overall, for the price point, it's a really great tool, but I'm not super convinced that it's an everyday kind of vlogging tool. I think it's along the lines of one of the DJI drones as well. something that you can use periodically to add a little bit of spice to your videos, but definitely doesn't replace your everyday shooter. And honestly, I think I'd rather have a drone. But it does do some cool time lapses that you can't get with a drone. So, is it worth the $300? That's up for you to decide. Great way to add a little bit of spice to your videos. Small, fits in your pocket, but at the end of the day, maybe a gimmick. Review of the DJI Osmo Pocket. Be sure to give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe for more videos every week. You can also find some great stuff at thebrandonscott.com. Leave a comment below. Let me know if the Osmo Pocket is something you're thinking about adding to your kit, or if it's something you think you're going to wait on and see if there's more improvements coming. In the meantime, we filmed a time lapse of us trying to film this outro, so enjoy our 27 attempts to get this outro right, and I'll see you next week.